Hello, superstars. Let's get started with this week's Norwood News newsletter edition for Thursday, March 3rd, 2022 for Norwood Elementary School, part of Baltimore County Public Schools. Happy St. Patrick's Day for you. That's coming up before our next newsletter, so we're going to go ahead and be a little festive and celebrate for that. Now, important dates that you want to know for this month of March: Monday, March 7th through Friday, March 11th. That's next week. If you're watching this on the week of the newsletter that it first comes out, that's going to be our Norwood Scholastic Book Fair. We're going to talk about that more in detail in a moment. Friday, March 18th, all BCPS schools dismiss 3 hours early. So here at Norwood, that means at 12:20 p.m. And Friday, April 1st, at the end of the month, also end of the marking period. So another 3 hours early dismissal. That means 12:20 as well for that day. Now, we're not going to go into as much detail as we have in the past with these videos. We just want to provide you with some supplemental information for the written one, and we can just use this as a way for you to get a summary and you decide what you want to focus on. And you can either call the school for more information or talk to your teacher or just look at the written newsletter for more information. So this is the section where we go into the callbacks of previous newsletters that have important information that you may want to look at as a reference. For example, if you want how to check the calendar for pre-planned school closures and early dismissals and holidays and important events, or if you want to update your emergency contacts to have somebody new pick up your child that's not on the list, or an absentee note template that you can print out if your child is sick and you want to excuse their absence, you can use that and it's all good to go. You just fill out certain key information and it's ready for you. So you can either print one out or you can ask for this and we'll get you a copy as well. So you can click on the video for that. And it goes a little more in detail about the policies of early dismissals and late arrivals and absentees. Now, there was a contest that we did last week to find a hidden word in the written version of the newsletter. And only 15 families managed to find it. Out of all the ones that looked at the newsletter, and it was actually, in fact, the word history written backward, as you see here. It was not part of a sentence. It was just randomly thrown in there, and you just had to kind of read it a little carefully to find it. So congratulations to one of our students, the parents of a second grade student who actually won the $100 gift card prize for the local Save a Lot grocer. We are doing this again this week for this next newsletter. So once again, if you find the hidden word, then look carefully and send it to me, Mr. Castro. And here's my information, dcastro@bcps.org, or you can call me and leave a voicemail after 4 p.m. at my number, but make sure that you include your name as the parent, your child's name as a student, and what the word actually is correctly. Don't give it to me backwards, and I want to hear it correctly. Good luck. Now, face masks and coverings are now optional as of March 1st. You probably are very well aware of this. You can click on the link. It's going to be included in the description of the video if you want to know more details. But there are two circumstances where they will be still required regardless. And that's going to be if you come back to school, if a child comes back after a shortened quarantine, and they have to wear those masks for 10 days from the date the symptoms began or the last date of exposure. So that's going to be a conversation with the nurse to help you identify that. And for individuals who have COVID-19 symptoms, not a diagnosis, but symptoms, and are being seen by the nurse, they have to wear it while they're in the nurse's office, the health suite. That's it. Other than that, it's completely optional and we'll respect everyone's choice with that, whether you wear it or not. Now, February coughing conversation wrap-up. We're simply going to provide here some more context about what you may have missed if you didn't participate in this session where Mr. Jeremiah talked about the community school initiative here at Norwood and what that may bring to us as additional funding and supports. And I, Mr. Castro, talked a little bit about how my role kind of helps bolster that too with existing services and supports that we have. So Mr. Jeremiah needs to hear from you, and I know he's met with a number of families already, but if you haven't had the ability to talk to him, he's open to still having one-on-one listening sessions based on your availability and his during the school hours. So reach out to him. His contact information is included here, and that way you can get in touch and he can hear your input and he has to ask you a few questions. So it's going to take a little bit, not too long, maybe 15 minutes, could be a little longer, but he wants to hear from you so he can have sufficient data to fulfill the requirements, and then we move forward with getting the new resources and supports for the school. So definitely reach out to him. The Scholastic Book Fair, going a little more into detail now, it's going to run from Monday, March 7th through Friday, March 11th. There in the past, there used to be an after-school component where families could join the students. Unfortunately, that is not happening. We are only having the in-school component, so no families can come. Just send your children with money, and they can buy what they want and they will get change returned back. So if they send them a good amount and they don't come back with anything, well, I don't know what they're doing then. So what you also need to keep in mind is that there is a link here that you can click on because there's going to be a book fair page. And so that it's going to actually have the catalog that you can look at and you can get an idea of what's there. And that way they may have specific, you can be more specific to what you give your children, or they can get a better idea when they come look. But they're going to come during their library class. So each class is going to have a chance to come to the book fair and visit it. And so that is all you need to know with regards to that. And we will have plenty of adults and volunteers to help the children while they're there. Last newsletter, we talked about a specific local clinic. There was one that was still left as of this date for March 16th at local Berkshire Elementary School. However, that has closed because it has filled up and has no more availabilities. So if you're looking for another service that can help you find a clinic or provider to get a COVID-19 vaccine for anyone in your family, just call 1-855-634-6829. That's the Maryland GoVAX number that sponsored those clinics, and they're run by the Department of Health locally and in the Baltimore County government and the state of Maryland. So you can just follow the menu prompts for your language, and it'll ask you for the things that you got to press a certain number for, and you can actually get to somebody live who can help you find those things if you have specific requirements or circumstances that you're looking for. It's actually very helpful. I tried it myself. And if not, you can also just click on the link and do it online yourself. And you can find a map that has all of these listed. Click on the one and you can schedule an appointment individually, and it can be just as easy as that. So you have several options for getting up to speed with where to go to get that done. Registration for pre-K and kindergarten is getting close for the next school year. We just want to remind you about two important things in terms of eligibility. Your child has to be 4 years old on or before September 1st of this year to be age eligible for pre-K for 2022 to 2023. If they are even a day late, September 2nd, they are not eligible, unfortunately. And your child has to be 5 years old on or before September 1st of this year to be age eligible for kindergarten, and that is mandatory. They have to go to school. That is not optional. Pre-K is different. But that's the age eligibility. Now, Thursday, April 24th, Friday, May 13th, and Tuesday, June 7th are just some of the days that we have picked for roundup events where we basically offer a lot of assistance to families to just quickly come in and finish up their applications. So if you want more information on this, call the school and we'll gladly provide that for you. Here are the overviews that we provide, the resources for families for upcoming chapters, new lessons in their curriculum. This is centered around math. So here you have them broken down by grade, English and Spanish. So just click on it and we'll have these links in the video and you can enjoy those resources together as a family to help manage the expectations by your child. And we've talked about the CCBC program before. It's just a program for anybody who wants to learn a specific kind of English that helps them geared towards academic success. So they learn a little bit about the language. It's a full free program sponsored by CCBC and Community College of Baltimore County. Just click on the link for the flyer to be able to see it's coming up for this area at the Northport Library on March 7th. So just look at the flyer and you'll see where you have to be and what time. That is it for this edition. Thank you very much for your time. And as always, keep on learning. Thank you.